We are going to see a very interesting and very powerful feature of pivot tables. We need raw data. This is a simple table with 1,500 rows and 9 columns. I want to create a report pivot table. I go to insert pivot table from table and click OK. This is how we regularly create a pivot table. I'm going to put amount in the total area, put expense type and card type. So we have a simple pivot table here. What are the problems with this pivot table? Two things. One is, suppose I want to count. Can I count? Yes, I can do count. But can I do distinct count? No, I cannot do distinct count. It's there, but it's inactive. So that's one limitation. Second, for whatever reason, I want some blank column here and I want to put some other data here. If I try to do that, pivot table is not going to allow me to do anything like that. So I want both these facilities. How do I go about doing it? So I go back to the raw data. I go to insert pivot table again. Of course, the data is in a table, but this time I do one extra thing. The data is still in table, but I'm saying while you're creating a pivot table out of it, let's add this to data model. And now it's going to use the same data, which is now going to get imported into data model to create that pivot table. Now I'm going to create this pivot table in an existing worksheet because we already have the older type of pivot table. So this is where I want it, so we can compare it easily. And in this pivot table as well, I will put exactly the same structure. Now I want distinct count. So if I go to summarize value by now, distinct count is available here. Distinct count is not available here. Why is this happening? Because this pivot table was created based on data in data model. The second problem is I wanted to add an extra column here. So suppose I say right click, shift, insert and shift cells right. Is it going to work? No, because this is also a pivot table. Same problem in both pivot tables. Copy this pivot table. Remember, the second one is based on data model. And now I get this button, OLAP tools, and I say convert to formulas. This is based on data model, so this button is available. The first one we created does not have OLAP tools enabled because that came from table. So now what happens? I click on convert to formulas. Now it just removes the pivot table part of it. Thus, numbers are still there. And now what is going to happen? Well, I can just move them around exactly the way I want. There'll be no error. But when the data changes, it is going to work. I'm going to take 4 rows, copy them and just paste them below. And now we'll come back to the pivot table and refresh. The data model is same, so it doesn't matter. Everything refreshed. So even though this is not a pivot table, it is refreshing when data changes, but it is giving you full flexibility of customizing the output format. So best of both worlds. So why is this thing called convert to formulas? Because if you look at the individual cell, it has cube member or cube value function, which works on an OLAP cube. OLAP means like a data warehouse. Data model actually is an OLAP cube. That's why it's called convert to formulas. So in summary, look at that checkbox and use it to your advantage. Sure, you found this useful, so you know what to do. Like, share, subscribe, bell, thanks and comments. But wait, just now you got introduced to the concept of data model. I have a detailed video which tells you many more benefits of using data model instead of importing data in Excel sheet. Have a look. So that's it for now. Thank you.